Trick it. Yeah, so I've been teaching here for about coming up on 2 years, and I've been mainly teaching the intro classes, the seven pillars technique classes. So the one, pillars 1 through 4 and 5 through 7, which is sort of the meat of the technique here and building the foundation of the process. And coming up soon, we're gonna be offering another film technique class that I'm gonna be teaching. So I'm really excited about that, to not only be teaching the technique and how to make a scene work and getting you into your process as an actor, but also starting to understand, you know, what it's like to act in front of the camera, what are the expectations of you in terms of working with different setups, in terms of angles, in terms of working with the process and the order and the setup of how films are filmed. It's a lot different than working on a scene in class or working on stage in terms of what you're asked to do, the order of things, the time that people take. And the processes of that and becoming comfortable with yourself on camera. So I'm really excited to start teaching that class. I like to try and keep myself in film, TV, and in theater in some kind of ways. So some of the recent projects I've been working on, I did a show called Buried in the Backyard, which is like a true crime kind of show. I got to dig up a body, as the title sort of signifies. I did a feature film that I don't know if I'm allowed to talk about yet or not, but I just did a new feature film, which is really cool. And I've been also working on some Shakespeare, directing and performing some Shakespeare stuff for schools, for the UC system. I mean, I think generally the thing is to really allow yourself to take advantage of being in a class and being in process, because I think a lot of times people think, oh, I can learn everything on the job. I can just start going and trying to, you know, book jobs and learn everything on the job. And you can learn a lot on the job. And there's a lot you can learn on the job that you can't learn in a class. I think that is important. I don't think you should just only be thinking about only training, because you do want to be able to apply it as well. But there are a lot of things you can't learn on the job because you don't have time to do it. You're expected to come in as somebody who knows what you're doing. Being able to be in class allows you to develop a process and a technique that you can rely on, that you'll know what you're doing. You're gonna be able to jump when you have to do an audition, when you have to take an adjustment, when you book the job and you have very little time to prepare, especially on film and television. You wanna be able to have a reliable process and technique. And I think being able to commit to training, and especially the training here, I think is very, there's a very strong sense of process and technique that gives you something you can hold on to and know you have when you are auditioning or when you book a job. I think acting for me is about, it's kind of about two things. It's about figuring out who are the different selves that you could be. You know, we talk about living under circumstances, or, you know, you're living truthfully under imaginary circumstances. And I think acting enables you to find out who might I have been if I had lived under different circumstances. So you kind of get a broader sense of who you are by knowing who you could have been or who you could be in different situations. And I think that's sort of a really important process for me that I want to take. And a lot of people won't take that process. A lot of people won't study this. And so I think the process of performing, the act of performing and being an actor, is me being able to do that and try to help share that with people who are watching, whether it's on stage or it's a movie or a TV show. You know, I think if I can be that careful with what I'm doing, hopefully I can get people to sort of expand their empathetic power as well, to kind of sort of see, oh, that's who I might have been under different circumstances as well, and help people understand other people a little bit better. So yeah, I think that's why I act, is it's kind of to grow my own sense of empathy and to try and help other people grow their sense of empathy and understanding where everybody's coming from. It is a very competitive field. It's a very chaotic and unreliable thing. And so it's something that everybody's always told me, other actors who are farther along than me have always told me, and then now I definitely agree with, is you do have to, there are valuable skills to gain from taking acting classes, no matter what you want to do. I mean, I really do think that there's a value for anybody to take an acting class because of what I said before, that you get to understand yourself in a broader sense and you get to understand other people in a broader sense. So I'd recommend anybody take at least an acting class or two. But if you want to also make it a career, I think you do have to eventually ask yourself, you know, is this something that I can't live without? And if you can't live without it, then that's when you know you have to do it. And that's another part of what made me decide that I had to pursue it as a career, because I wouldn't be happy if I didn't pursue it. Because it is very competitive and you have to have that feeling, I think, to do something so kind of crazy in certain kind of ways. But that said, I really do think that that there's value in it for no matter what your career path is.